Hey guys and girls, welcome back to Poor Man's Bushcraft. As you can see from the title, this video is going to be the ultimate finds for this year. And as you can see right now, I am working on that very video. Excuse me, getting over a little bit of a cold. What I wanted to talk to you guys about real quick before you finish watching this video, and it's going to be a long one, so please bear with me and try to watch it through, you know, throughout the whole video. Because as I go through some of the stuff that I did find in this deal, I will be making some offer me this or offer me that. And some of it is still available and some of it is not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, as I go through this video, I will put up the words offer, you know, make offer. And if it's something you're interested, shoot me an offer, you know, whether it's trade, cash, however you want to do it. You see something you like that I say offer and we'll work something out. So sure. Hope you guys enjoy this video. Like I said, this is going to be a little bit of a long one. And, I will explain that the video starts off with four trunks. I only bought two of them and I had already mixed my stuff in with this stuff. So there's a little bit of confusion, but I apologize for that. I was just so excited about getting this stuff and didn't even think about making a video until after the fact. So, at that note, bear with me, stick with me. Hope you enjoy this video and hope you see something you like or gives you an idea of something you might need for your preps, survival gear, or just something that you could collect. Alright, thanks for watching and on to the video. Hey guys and girls, welcome back to Poor Man's Bushcraft. I know a lot of you out there like good finds. And I definitely like a good find. What you see before you are four very big trunks. Well, three good trunks and a big one. And that is my find for this week. And I found this stuff on OfferUp. And I'm going to show you what I found. And then I'm going to tell you what I paid. And then I'm going to show you the one item that pretty much pays for that whole thing right there. So if you stay tuned, we'll dive into one of these boxes real quick and see what's in there. So we'll be right back. All right, guys, welcome back. We are in the first box. And as you can see, sitting right on top is the old Woodland, the early Molly 2 Systems assault pack. Still real good shape, so you know, whatever that's worth. The second one is the newer ACU assault pack. Now I did put a little bit of my medical stuff in this, but there was some already in here. Some of the stuff that was in here was a cat tourniquet and this bench made extrication tool, if you want, seat belt cutter, whatever. So there's a couple good finds. Now mind you, that this was all stuff that was put, you know, together, bought on OfferUp. If you don't know about OfferUp, check it out. Usually you can find some pretty cool stuff on there. Some of the other things that were in here was this stethoscope. So that's a cool find. There were some of these exercise bands, but you know, for all intents purposes, you know, leaving them in the medical kit, you can use these for rehabilitation after an injury, you know, in a bug out situation. You could use these as a tourniquet to draw blood, or not to draw blood through these, don't get me wrong, but you know what I mean. Or just stabilization of, you know, somebody's extremities. This one was also in here, and after looking at this one fairly close, this one is a German first aid kit that is completely steel stocked, and there are scissors and pads, and some of them I don't speak German, so I don't know what they are, but I'm sure if I dug into them, that would definitely be a pretty decent first aid kit. So that was in there. That's the cool part of it, you know, a cool part of the find. A couple of the other ones that were in this, like I said, some of my stuff has been mixed in with this stuff, so bear with me. But let's see, what do we have here? We have some of my first aid stuff. Okay, right here is where I was talking about. Okay, some more stuff that was in this finds was an H bandage. There's a German bandage. That is a blood drawing tourniquet, you know, the rubber ones, and another German bandage there. So great bunch more first aid stuff, plus, you know, that pack, which is awesome. Like I said, some of my stuff is mixed in here, so most of what's in there now is my stuff, with the exception of those books. And they are the Engineer's Field Data Book, the Explosives and Demolitions Book for Engineers, and a complete land nav and map reading guide. So some stuff that, you know, definitely want to learn up a little bit on. And like I said, you know, keep in mind what I'm showing you, and then I will tell you what I paid for all this stuff. So you've seen the CAT tourniquet, the first aid kit, the Benchmade extrication tool, the packs, the stethoscopes, the first aid kit, and that being the first box. So stick with me and I will open up another box and we'll see what was in that one. So here we are on to box two. Some of you might recognize this as my box. Yes, it is, but I'm relocated some of the stuff that was in it to this box so that I could use the other two boxes for my own thing. Do we need to adjust this light? No, we're good. Okay, so big knife, some ski pants. Actually looked these up online, and these are expensive, but not something I really want. Okay, this big monstrosity here, and I'm going to back up so that you guys can see this thing as I hold it up. This is called a crewman's bag, or I will put the real name for it down below. This is not technically a backpack. It does have backpack straps on it, but technically it is not meant to carry as a ruck, so it is not called a backpack. But you can see these straps are huge. They're like Alice straps with a little bit of Molly going on at the same time. But here is that bag. And I am holding right here at the top of the top compartment. This is three compartments. I looked this up on YouTube and I found one other video on this thing. But it's combined of a Molly pack, an Alice pack, and God only knows what else is going on here. But you have the sleeping bag compartment. There's a middle compartment that has two of these pockets that's like on an Alice pack. And then the top, there are two compartments. There's a big pocket on the front here, and then the main compartment, which is here. And none of these three compartments are accessible to each other. These are all three independent pockets with a zipper here and a zipper here, and then the straps that strap them all together. Now, where this resembles some of the old Alice and Molly packs is the top is that open up thing that we're all familiar with, the old you know, the older pack or the newer packs and some of the older ones. So that monstrosity is in there. Price wise, I haven't been able to find a price on these. Somewhere in the $100 range, I believe, is what they were, you know, a couple of them. I'm sure you could probably find them cheaper than that. But this is a crewman's bag, and I will give you the real name for it later or down in the description. Not a backpack, but can be carried as one, and it is freaking huge. Okay, moving on. is this Admin backpack briefcase thingamajig. Pretty cool. Wear it like a backpack, but it's pretty much a briefcase. Nothing real too fancy about it. Let's go ahead and bring this back in. So nothing real too fancy about it. Just, you know, it's a briefcase, but it's ACU and it's kind of tactical. Got the Admin pouch there. I don't know if I'm in focus or not, but wheelchair, here we go. So that was in there. A Tank Crew soft helmet liner with Bose radio headphones still attached to it. So part of that find. You know, if anybody's interested in something like this as collector and be willing to, you know, throw me an offer on it, that's one that we'll throw out there as throw me an offer on this thing if you something you would want, and we'll see what we can work out. So there's that one. So then we move on into a bunch of ACU clothing. There was tons of it. This is a full suit. There was hats, t-shirts, just gobs of kind of clothing. So there's that. That's box two. Stick with me one more, at least one more time, and we'll go into another box and see what we got. All right, we are down to the last two boxes. Now, I showed you a breakdown of the other two boxes, and most of the stuff that was in those actually came in these two boxes. This was the box deal. This was the find. Both of these being full. And before I even thought about doing a video, I had pulled all the stuff that was in these out, found what I wanted to keep. Some of it was the kind of stuff that you just automatically start throwing away. But this was the deal. Those two boxes full of stuff, some of it you've seen in here, the packs, the backpack, the medical stuff, some ACUs. Before we dive into these, let me show you real quick. One of the things that was in this lot was these bad boys right here. And if you are familiar with Oakley, you know these are Oakleys. And these are those military Oakleys. I wanted to find out what these were, so I looked online. A new price for these. Just not searching real hard and looking for the absolute cheapest ones. Just open it up and, you know, whatever the most popular one was for sale of this actual style was $130. Okay. Now, take in mind what you've already seen and what I'm going to show you in this trunk here, the one on top. The one on the bottom is actually my big Molly 2-pack and my smaller 3-day excursion pack that I have showed you guys before, and then a few odds and ends. But just to show you how big that trunk is that's actually holding a full-size Molly 2-pack, the current issue, the OCP multicam, whichever, you know, Scorpion, whatever you want to call it these days. But so what was in these two boxes and was, you know, a breakup of what's in there. We had the Oakleys, and then going into this one, you can see that there is quite a bit of stuff in here. Now, focus in a little bit. Two sets of boots. Let me adjust this camera one more time so I don't bump into it a dozen times. Two sets of boots. We have this style here and this style here. Both of them looking brand new. Just happened to be my size too. So we got those in there. Get this trash out of here. A brand new pack of these kind of a foliage green t-shirts, one of which I am actually wearing today. The other boots, a boonie, an ACU boonie.
ACU cold weather mask. And I'm not big on ACU, but you know, if it's there, I'm going to go ahead and hold on to it. And you know, maybe somebody in the group or you know, whoever bugs out with me can you know, take advantage of those. Grenade, don't know much about the brand, but they are super rubbery on the grips, and they have a cool picture of a grenade on there. I'm not even focused on those. There we go. So there you go, the grenades. We'll refocus back down here. What else did we get in here? We got repair kits for like sleeping mats and packs and stuff. They repair kits for the ACU or the multicam gear. So we've got some of those. Super soft leather gloves. There's another one of the boots. ACU combat shirt. The Army ACU pillow, which is kind of cool. You know, I'm not real big on them, but like I said, ACU is still usable. Diving down in here, again, there's my poncho liner because I did relocate some of this stuff. Some shoe inserts, t-shirts. This was not in on that deal, and this is one I got a video coming up for you guys on. This one is from the Fort Bragg Surplus, and we'll do a video on that one. So this was in there. This was in on that deal. So just another bladder, so I can hook up a pack with a bladder. We got about three or four of these PT belts, which are always nice to have if you're just out training with your packs. This one is reflective, highly visible. These are the kind with just a reflective stripe on them. Oh Lord, what else do we got in here? We got canteen holders. That's my boonie. These I was really surprised about, and that's two of those all-weather riding pads, right in the rain, whatever you want to call them. This is a brown version. I usually see the green versions, but these have friendly unit symbols, enemy unit symbols, class of supply, tactical mission graphics, so you know how what graphics to use as far as, you know, marking out a trail or something like that. Sketch examples, you know, mapping and plotting and all that. I mean, all kinds of cool useful information in the backs of these. So that's one I really like. Some of the current issue ACU pattern multicams. I am actually wearing the pants right now. Carabiner. There were three or four of these bad boys. These are for your headbands so that you are reflective on your headband. Some Woodlands, playing cards, a knot tie-in card, some Army stickers. This one was cool when I found it. This is unexploding ordnance procedures, and it shows you the different kinds of unexploded ordnance and what you should and shouldn't do with them. My personal opinion is that keyword right there, avoid. So some more of those, some Army socks, another fix-it kit, and it just, you know, that's all my cold weather gear that I already owned. But you see, I mean, two full boxes of stuff and more stuff, so it was an awesome find. Now, like I said earlier in the video, that I was going to tell you about these being the $100 on the cheap end, let's say $100 on the cheap end, and then put together everything else you've seen and put it all in these two boxes, like that tanker's helmet, the two sets of boots that are practically brand new, and what I ended up paying for all of this is $100. It has been one of the best finds I've had so far. I was stoked when I found it on OfferUp. So I am highly suggesting, recommending. If it works, I'll even order you guys to go to your phone apps or your computer and look up OfferUp. Go ahead and join it. It doesn't cost anything to sell. There's no final value fees. There's no listing fees. And the cool thing about it is that if you've seen a lot like this, and it was just this one trunk, and somebody had $75 on what was in this trunk, there's a little button that says offer. You make them a counter offer. If they are okay with it, they will, you know, say, yeah, I'm up for that, or they might counter bid you. So it's not a set thing like eBay or Craigslist where they're like, you know, don't make me no lowball offers. And that, I mean, obviously we don't lowball people too bad, but a deal like this deal, these two boxes, when it first got listed and I watched it for a little while, the ask price was $170. It set in that deal for a week or so, and I continued to watch it. It got marked sold, and I was like, should have bid on it. Should have made an offer on it. It came back up the same day at $100. I was not going to haggle too much with the guy at that point. He'd done come down 70 bucks. So for 100 bucks, I got the Oakley glasses, the crewman bag, the two assault packs, that admin backpack briefcase thingy, the boots, the t-shirts, I mean just everything that I've showed you that is new to me was in on this deal. And for 100 bucks, I don't think it's too bad. So thanks for watching. Hope I inspired you to check out some places like OfferUp. Check Craigslist even, you know. Sometimes people will take a little bit less because it's been up there too long. And hope you enjoyed the finds. We'll see you guys on the next video. Until then, take care.